So welcome everybody. Now we will be starting the class of Abhidhamma and Dhammapada and Abhidhamma. So I request Bhante ji to start with the Gatha plus. Please.
Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
You start with the homage do there. Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha. Okay? We recite together Namo Tassa, Buddha, Rado, Sangha, for three times. Namo Tassa, Bhagavato, Arahato, Sama, Sambo, Tassa. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. My innings in the Upasaka Upasika. Joining together and the support to bodhisattvas to be long distance. We have the duty because we are Buddhist monk. You have duty because you are upasaka, upasika. So monk nuns, they have duty to study Dipitaka, to teach Dipitaka, Buddha Vachana, to share and this the message of the Buddha. This is monk nun's duties. The Upasaka, Upasika duty, they also even to study, even to listening, even to follow, and then they should be supported by their finance. So by this way, support for Buddha Sasana to be long distance. Now Buddha Sasana is 2,300 years, the journey is coming. Buddha Sasana, long time, journeys, so over 2,300 years. Because Upasaka, Upasika, because monk nuns, they support by their energies. So, according to that, we try to study Buddha Vachana and then trying to teach and trying to share. This is our duties. We start Buddha, the Buddhist work. Basically, I was in the monastery in my age, six years old, no? My life, 6 years old. Now I'm near there, 60 years old. So I'm start, there is a Buddhist study, literatures, start from 6 years old. After that, in 9 years old, I become Samanera. And 20 years old, I become Upasamra the monk like? The truth is that my life's journey, only study. Here and there. So study. Six to 70 years during the time, but not yet enough.
5.2 kilometers
for the Buddhist knowledge. So now we take this course, especially for rainy season. Vassa start. July full moon day to August, October full moon day, for the 3 months rainy season. But this, we are, you know, as much as, you know, to start early, after in this month. So basically, our course target for the rainy season, Vassa. So, previous month, in summer vacation time, we took this Dhammapada course. Yes, at the time that we complete, there is the Vagga. Yamaga Vagga, Abhidhamma Vagga, and the Chika Vagga. So at the time, many buses, many stories, the already finished in some vacation time. So we took for 3 days and 1 week. So now we change time, especially morning class. And then change season, summer to raining. And the change, that is the audience. The changing audience is before the only our groups, from the Pune, from the Mumbai, who are very friendly Upasaka Upasik. But at this time, who is belong to the, all the people from around the world. So at the time, we should think about that. If we do continuously the Mabra goes at the time, many information will be less for the international people. So that's why we should start again is start with the beginning of this Dhammapada, the Yamaka Vagga. So the who are all students, study already 3 Vagga, bars, the story, discussion, the question, the answers, everything. They already study. Please be patient for that, because we want to start from that is the beginning. Vagga, Yamaka Vagga. So Dhammapada and Abhidhamma. Abhidhamma means Abhidhammattha Sangaho. Abhidhammattha Sangaho, about the Chitta, Chidasika, the Pukainaka, Rupa, and Nibban. So these are also, we should try to introduce to the people. So basically, I take Abhidhamma class every Saturday for the Mumbai University. The students. This is my regular class there. So here, we take two subjects, Dhammapada and Abhidhamma. So we try to introduce the two subjects for the people who are trying to, you know, contact with the Dhamma, Buddha Dhamma. So your Dhamma Pashti, Soman Pashti, the Buddha explained. So who know Dhamma? They're able to see me. So who understanding the my message, the Dhamma, they're able to meet me. So according to that the Buddha message, whenever we want to see Buddha, whenever we want to understand it, we want to know about the Buddha Dhamma. So we try to touch these literatures. Literature means a message. These are called Buddha Vachana. So basically, we are messenger, Dhamma messenger. Whenever we know systematically from the teacher, a long time journey or our experience, this literature, we should try to the sharing this knowledge of literatures. So we try to give the people and this message, Dhamma. And then we were trying to mention about that what you are sending to sentence. This is our duty. So Buddha message. That is Dhamma. This is Vachana. This is the Dhamma. This is the Vachana. Is the present the Buddha. Present Buddha. If the, we know Dhamma, we know Buddha. If the, we understand Dhamma, we were see the Buddha in present time. So Buddha Dhamma is the need in these times, everywhere, every time, the views, sound, the smell is, you know, very much pollution. Whenever we see many pollution there, not clearly, not peacefulness. Whenever we hear every time, there is much pollution there, so much unpleasant sound, the present voice there. So at the time, our minds, our hearts, our life is not fresh. We more and more dire. So we more and more weakness in the weakness because of Jews, because of sounds twice around the world. So at the time, we should see the peacefulness of the views, how to make peaceful our heart, our mind, our life. So we should try to listen in the peacefulness of voice, the peacefulness of voice sounds, the witches to make the for our mind, our heart, our life. Yeah, more and more, you know, to be fresh, to be complete with the energy. So the Buddha, the message is to give the energy of our heart, our mind, our life. So how to go, how to see, how to understand it. But you like this guidance, the comment from the Buddha message. Our Buddha coming to this world, he want to talk the people only to them, which is the real good, which is real not good. Only to them, punya apunya, the kusala akusala. Buddha, he coming to this world, the one to talk the people, which is kusala, which is akusala. Only two then, one and two. Because in this world, no understanding what is good, what is bad, what is good, what is evil, which is kusala, which is akusala, what is punya, what is apunya, not clear. They don't understand. So that's why the programs and the more and more, the forest more and more everywhere, because of the ignorance of good and bad. Our human society, God message from any philosopher, culture, tradition, religions, the most of messages are not clearly to understand it. Which is good, which is bad. So Buddha Vachana is to talk directly, which is good, which is bad, so to understand it. After that, we try to follow, we try to practice. So at the time, the good result come into our life with the energy. The energy coming to our heart, our mind, to our life. At the time, we are happiness of life. So if we have the full energy of mind, the full energy of heart, full energy of our body, life, so at the time, our society, our world will be the peacefulness and peaceful, happy, in the happy, Yeah, very nice environment, very the common. So that's why, first of all, then we should know like this message from the Buddha, Vachana. So for that, you know, we're trying to do like this online course. So I very much thank you for Upasika. Yeah, we shall the Gaidhani. So basically, she is from the moment. Now in day she living in the America. She study for PhD. Her topic is about Kanti Parami. Why she moved to America for the study of Buddha Vachana. She want to know more and more this Buddha Vachana. She want to do the Buddha Sasana. Especially to talk, composing the book, to supporting something like this. In Mumbai, the university, she's not study very well the Abhidhamma Sangaho. After that, she moved to the America for study Buddha Vachan. So this the online course is coming because of Upasika family, on the trying, you know, do for that. So that's why. Thank you so much for your the family. So basically, we have the one the association, the International Abhidhamma Society. International Abhidhamma Society. This is society is start from the 2009-2010, and Pune University. The I start teach the Abhidhamma. So who are joining at the time from each country inside Pune University. So after that, this student part, we should do one society, International Abhidhamma Society. So this society is available, but not much work activities. But I'm the founder, so I'm trying to teach every year. Basically, always I'm still with the teaching, learning the every day. Whenever I reach anywhere, so I'm trying to start to teach. The teach means trying to sharing like this Abhidhamma, Dhammapada, Buddha Vachana. I'm not talk without book. I'm not teach without reference. I'm not compose any, without reference Buddha Vachana. Whatever we talk, whatever we discussion, whatever we composing, everything depends on the Buddha Vachana. So at the time, basically, whenever we talk, we discussion, we teach, that is not our own ideas. Our the war is like a transformation to sharing from the original text. So our wish, people should touch. Should be meet with the original message. This original message that from the Dhammapada, that is Buddha, Buddha there. You should see, you should meet, you should go. So other than the people, no mind, no time. Yeah, I worry about that. No mind, no time. Not interesting. And then they are busy with their work job. Whenever we talk, there are no minds. Whatever we teach, there are no times. Yeah, I have a lot of experience in the, you know, India. In India, I was studying for 10 years in Pune University. That's why I'm the have the, a lot of experience. Whenever I teach the people, yeah, very difficult to join because there are no times. And these days, everybody busy with their the job. So that's why it's difficult to touch. So we understand it nowadays. So Upasaka, Upasika is very busy, more and more, no time for the Dhamma. Yeah, that's why there are no mind for the Dhamma. So during the time that we try to call, we try to, you know, contact, we try to do such a like this, you know, Dhamma festival, you know, online Dhamma. So at the time, some Upasaka, Upasika, they're trying to contact, they're trying to listen, they're trying to, you know, study. Yeah. So that's why not easy to do, you know, everything in this day. So that's why we are talking about the, you know, thank you. So like this. So these are not only for us. These are for our family, these are for our society, these are for our country, these are for our universe, our world. Put a message, the goal, not here and there, separate the here and there, you know, where we, the goal resides, the way we come in, something like this. Our wish is there. So according to our duty, responsibility, as like the previous, you know, generation, they also work as like this. We also doing as like this. So that's why we should be happy by ourselves. Because we able to do, not able to understand, not able to a discussion like this, higher, you know, Dhamma. That's why we should, you know, be happy for our life. So this, the online course, the especially the contact by the Indonesian Abhidhamma Society, okay? India, USA, Myanmar. So like this, we should understand. So we should start this, our course. When we teach this Dhammapada Abhidhamma, the from the text, we try to talk text. We able to touch this text message. So at the time, you are understanding by yourself. You direct to see the Buddha. Direct, you know, understanding the by your heart, your mind. So openly, the whenever you have doubt, the go choose the please ask any question and the please the discussion. Yeah, you can do the openly. As long as the, we have knowledge, we can reply, you know, whatever any problem regarding with this subject, we try to the mention. Okay. Okay, we should start the Dhammapada. The Dhammapada, as you know, including in the Khutka Nikaya, our Gorma Buddha. His age 35 years old, he attained Buddha, Samasambuddha Buddha, under the Bodhi tree. Our Gorma Buddha, our Saitata Gorma Buddha, not according to India. In Myanmar, not say Saitata Gorma Buddha. So here say Gorma Buddha. Even though they not use Gorma, they use only Buddha. So our Gorma Buddha became Samasambuddha under the Bodhi tree in Bodh Gaya, India, at his age 35 years. So he teach his Dhamma everywhere for 45 years. Our Gorma Buddha passed away his age 80 years in Kushinagara Garden. Kushinagara in India. So for 45 years, the Buddha message everywhere. After demise, the Buddha, 700 Arahanta Bhante Tipitaka Chalabhinya Arahanta Bhante, to perform the first Sangha Council, Prathama Singhayana, and the Rajagaha Vivara Mount, on the Vivara Mount. After Gorma Buddha Parinibbana, after 3 months, Gorma Buddha passes away, enter into Mahaparinibbana. So the Aranda Bhante Tipitaka, the Chalabhinya, Aranda Bhante, they make first Sangha comes, Prathama Singhayana. So now the Singhayana is for 6 in India, 3 times. First Singhayana, second Singhayana, third Singhayana. The first Singhayana in Rajagaha, second Singhayana in Vishali, third Singhayana in the Patna, Patalipur. 4 Singhayana in the Sri Lanka, the 5th and the 6th Singhayana in the Myanmar. That's why that is the Singhayana festival the 6 times. So in the first Singhayana, Arahanta Bhante, they arrange the collect all information around the world, So they arranged three Pirka and the five Nikaya. Some Buddha Vachana belong to the Vinaya, some are belong to the Sutta, some are belong to the Abhidhamma. That's why three Pirka come in. The Vinaya Pirka, the Sutta Pirka, Abhidhamma Pirka. This is the order of the Buddha Vachana, Buddha message. As according to Nikaya, some are long discourse, some are short discourse, some are gathering as 1, 2, 3 groups. So, high Nikaya there, Sayuta Diga Nikaya, the Majjhima Nikaya, Sayuta Nikaya, Enguttara Nikaya, Enkhotika Nikaya. The five Nikaya there. Three Pirka, five Nikaya. Three Pirka, five Nikaya is, you know, each other, there is a link. According to Pirka, the wind of Pirka, Sauta Pirka, Abhidhamma Pirka. So according to Nikaya, Dika Nikaya, Majjhima Nikaya, Sayuta Nikaya, Enguttara Nikaya, Khotika Nikaya. So, Dhammapada, the book, text is included in the Khotika Nikaya, including in Suttanta Pirka. Suttanta Pirka and the Khotika Nikaya. Okay, Dhamma, the Buddha, Dhamma is a Dhamma. Dhamma is a Megaphala Nibbana. Dhamma is a Bodhipakshiya Dhamma, which is association of enlightenment. Bodhipakshiya Dhamma. So, Buddha means knowledge of the way, some meanings there. So the Dhammapada is a collection of Buddha Vachana from a seed. Basically, this is like notes books, notes the Dhamma books in the Tipitaka. These are meaning of Dhammapada. Sometimes this Buddha is way, method, how to go to the enlightenment. How to go to the, you know, Bodhipakshiya Dhamma. Bodhipakshiya Dhamma is a way to the Nibbana. Such like this meaning is there. So who I want to go to the Nibbana, who I want the liberation from the samsara, I should study the Dhammapada. Dhammapada, the day is very much popular in the world because Dhammapada is very closely with the society, about minister, about the monk, about the family life, about the culture, about the politics, about the economy, about the good person, about the bad person, about the children, about the old people, about the banga, about the beggar. So many kinds of information there. So many kinds of the guidance, like you know, the car driver, you know, anywhere, any position, any condition, they're able to drive, and they know, you know, how to drive safely. So such like this Buddha also like the good driver. Any condition coming, any problem coming, any position coming. So other than the Buddha gave message to us, Buddha guidance to us, how to do, what to do, how to drive, how to go, how to move, how to thought, such a like this, ideas, information, where we see in these textbooks. So we are trying to discuss, study Dhammapada and this the Abhidhamma also. Abhidhamma, we want to introduce again, because our last 2020, we already, there is conduct this Abhidhamma course. At the time to do chapters, we complete. So now we want to, you know, revision for that, to, you know, remind for you about chitta, about the chittasika. That's why so we add here Dhammapada in Abhidhamma. So our class they do, you know, end of the Vassa, end of Vassa, end of the rainy season, or the 3 months or 4 months, 1 month we meet 4 days. According to time of what, 3 months, 4 months, but we study time is not much. So don't be run from our course. You should try to keep in touch, they do finish. Okay? So now the here, 9 o'clock. So basically, we usually take the class in the Mumbai, the Pune, with the Indian people, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, sometime. So like this, unlimited. Now we should take care, because yeah, many international people, maybe they're here. So that's why we should take care for that also. So now the time that we are, yeah, in Myanmar, 8 to 10 or 11, okay? So from the India, 7 to, yeah, 10, 9, 10, like this, no? So anyway, today we are trying to introduce about this text, okay? So the Dhammapada, 26 types of groups, what are they? And then how many verses? The 423 verses there. And then how many stories? The 305 the stories there, no, in the Dhammapada textbook. The Vagga, 26 Vagga, the 423 the verses, and the 305 the stories there. So as much as even though they are large, you know, the verses, the stories there, we able to teach, we able to study as much as, okay? Okay, start the Yamaka Waga. So Yamaka Waga is a pairs. No, Yamaka means pairs. Kusala, Agusala, good and bad, there is the pairs there. So very nice. The chapters, the beginning of the Dhammapada. So anyway, now we have the tradition, the whenever we, you know, teach the before teaching learning, the we homage to the Buddha Dhamma Sangha. So we should start our the online course, the with the homage to the Buddha, Namo Dasa, Bhagavato, Arhato, Sammasambuddhas, the 43 times. Okay? We should read together 43 times. Namo Dasa, Bhagavato, Arhato, Sammasambuddhas. Namo Dasa, Bhagavato, Arahado, Sama, Sambuddhasa. Namo Dasa, Bhagavato, Arahado, Sama, Sambuddhasa. Okay, in Yamagawaga, that is the first stanzas, Chakupala, the stories. So we should read, we should discuss the first, you know, that is Gatha. Manobhavingama Dhamma. Manositha Manomaya Manasachi Badukthina Bhashatiwa Karodiwa Tadonan Dukha Manuidi Chagangwa Wahado Badam. Very famous, very popular in the world. Most of the people combated the Buddhism because of this gatha. Manopavingama Dhamma, Manositha Manomaya. Manasachi Padukthina Bhashtiwa Krodiwa. Tatonan Dukha Manuidi Chakanwa Wahado Badam. Okay, Manopavingama Dhamma. In translation, the augmented phenomena have the mind as their foreigner. Manopogama Dhamma. So here, Dhamma meant the phenomena. So Dhamma is the Dhamma. According to Abhidhamma, Dhamma is the chittasikas. Because Mana is chaitas. Mano, mana, chaita, same. So consciousness, you know, mind, consciousness is the same here. Mano, mind. The Bhavingama, a foreigner. Mind is a foreigner. Mind is a leader. And chittasika dhammas. But here, all mental phenomena, all mental phenomena have the mind as they are foreigner. So mana is mano, mana means chitta, dhamma is chittasika. So chitta in chittasikas, chitta is foreigner, chitta is leaders. So according to Abhidhamma, chitta chittasika is always arising together, disappearing together, ikobara, ikanidora. Mana and Dhamma is arising together always, cessation together always, ikobara, ikaniro. So taking object also together, ikalambana. The base. Vuttu also the same. the base, saying what to. So this is according to Abhidhamma. So according to here, Mano Dhamma. Okay, they are arising together, which is more activity, which is the foreigner. So mana is Bhubhangama, Bhubhangama, the foreigner. So mana is Vinyane Khanda. Yeah, this is information from the Abhidhamma. Mana Chitta is Vinyane Khanda. Dhamma Chittasika is Vedana Khanda, Sinye Khanda, Sankhara Khanda. Chitta Chittasika is called Nama. You know, Nama and Rupa, according to, you know, Abhidhamma, this universe only Nama and Rupa. Mentality, the physicality, mind and matter, physical, Nama and Rupa, only one and two. Whenever we see, whenever we hear, whenever we got smell, taste, touch, thought, only two then, some are Nama, some are Rupa. Yeah, some are Nama Rupa also. All universe has two things, some are mentality, some are physicality. Okay, the mentality, Nama, is what is only Chaita and Chittasika. These are Nama. Here, Mana and Dhamma. This is Nama. This is mentality. All mental, the phenomena, has the mind as their foreigner. Okay? So, Chaita and Chittasika, all. The Vinyana Khanda, Sinya Khanda, Sikhara Khanda, Vinyana Khanda. And the four, that is the Khanda, four groups there, and the mentality. Okay? So Vinyana Khanda, the Mana Chaita is the leaders. That's why in Buddha explained in the Sutta, Chaitena Niyati Loko. This the whole world is the follow to the Chaita. The whole universe is based on the our minds, our mana, our consciousness. Our mind is good, this universe is good. Our mind is not good, this universe is not good. Our mind is good, our life is good. Our mind is not good, our life is not good. Our action, our speaking, our thought depends on the, our minds, our mentality, our manner. Our society also like this, our country also like this, our universe also like this. Chaita has power. Everything are based on the chitta, mana. I want to sit, that's why I'm sitting here. I want to talk, that's why I'm talking here. I want to eat, that's why I eat. So everything is based on the mind. The mind is foreigner. Leaders, even though mana and dhamma, chitta and chittasika are rising together, during the mana and dhamma, the mana is a foreigner, the dhamma is based on the mana. Chitta arise, chittasika arise. Chitta not arise, chittasika not arise. Mana coming, dhamma also coming. Mana not coming, dhamma not. Yes. Noble Vingama Dhamma, all mental phenomena have mind as a foreigner, the basically, the mind the foreign of mean that, you know, chitta seekers. Manosita, sita, chit. Consciousness has the all mental phenomena. Had the mind as their chief. The Bobagama Sita. Similarly, Manomaya, their mind made, their mind made. So that's why the Chitta arise, Chittisika arise. Like the Chitta is a prime minister. The prime minister come in, other minister also come in together. So Chitta is like leaders. The Chittisika is like other faculties. All mental phenomena have the mind as their foreigner. They have the mind as their chief, their mind made. This is the definition of Chitta and Chittisika. A definition of mentality, definition of our mind self. We cannot see our mind, our chitta, because the very first, compare less. Even though Buddha say, compare less. The chitta is the very first. During the Isaka, crowless or chitta is already finished. Crowless. Bhashati manasachi paduktina. Okay, here. Manasachi paduktina. Bhashati krodi. So whatever we talk, whatever we do, bhashati krodi, with the, our mind. So our mind is like a producer, produce our power, the our action. The why I can talk like this? Because the mind, mana. The why I'm doing any action? Because of my mind producer or talking and the doing. That's why mana sa che baduktina bhashti krodi. If the one, anyone, speaks or acts bhashti krodi with the evil mind, evil mind, baduktha mana. So mana, the baduktha mana means the akushala, chitta. So mana saji baduktha means the akushala chitta. Akushala chitta is the lobha, dosha, moha. So I talk with the lobha chitta. I do any action with the lobha chitta. With the dosha chitta, with the moha chitta, yes, possible. Manasachi paduktina bhashti krodi. This is the action coming because of mana. Mana is real producer of our life, our movement, our action, our thought. So here, bhashti krodi. The power, the action, the here, but the mentality action also, including here. Because we have the three action, the bodily action, the power action, and the mentality action. The here, you know, bodily action here, the power action here. But including the automatically, mentality action also here automatically. We should understand it like this. If the one the speaks or as the with the an evil mind, okay, evil mind, the we did, we done, the we talk, the we did any, finish or not? Oh yeah, finish. That don't know. After that, that don't know. After that. Dukkha manuedi. Dukkhas follow him just as the. Tadona Dukkha manuedi. Dukkha anuedi. Dukkha sufferings follow him just as. Chakka iwa wahado badam. The chakka means we, okay? The follow the footprint, bada. Bada means footprint of the house that drives the cart. So similarly like this. Similarly, the we, the follow the footprint. The house that dropped the cart. So the dukkha followed to him. Because his speech, Musawara, Bishuna was a frusa, was a superplopa. He talking lying, he abused, he shouting, it device speech, useless speech. Musawara, Bishuna was a frusa, was a hard speech, superplopa. Useless speech, Vashti. So like this action, reaction the coming. That's why that don't do come with. Resero action is dukkha. Because so, his action is not good. Because so, his mind is not good. Mind is evil, action also evil, result also evil. It's the procession there. If the mind is good, yeah, our action is good, result will be good. This is the way of life, the nature of life. This is the universal truth. Not belong to the any person, any culture, any tradition, any religions, any people, any country. Nature is nature. This is the message come from here. Manasaja Brodhana Bhashri Karodi. Yeah, we talk, we do, we thought, with the evil mind. What about Risa? Dukkha. Chakkanwa Wahadobra. The example, the weed, the follow, the hoofprint, the house, the doors, the car. So we are driver. Any position, any condition, anywhere, anytime, we should manage our mind. Our mind is like our four wheeler. We drive safely. Otherwise, the dangerous point is there. The every action should be good, properly run on the way safely. Yeah, result is good, reach very easily, safely. So this is the message that comes from this gatha verse. Okay, Upaska Mukherjee, are you ready to talk, to discussion something about this gatha, okay?
Okay, yes, Bhante. Thank you, Bhante. So, in today's class, the ABS told him about the International Abhidhamma Society also, and why he wanted to start the class. The basic preamble is given by him. And this class we have started again. So we are very much thankful to Vaishali, Vaishali Gaidhani. She is the PhD student there in California, USA. With this, Bhante ji has given some initial teachings. What are the duties of the Upasaka, Upasika? What our duty is to support the Dhamma and Sangha? What is the duty of the bhikkhu and nuns? They are sharing the message, Buddha Vachana. And our duty is to give the Sangha Dhamma to the Buddha Sasana. The Buddha Sasana is 250 years old. See that? Our Buddha Vachana is still continuing. Pandit talked about himself, that when he was 6 years old, he became a Samanera. And then, at the age of 20, he took Upasampada and then he became a full monk. And he is today he is 60 years old. So he takes learning the Dhamma since last 54 years. So his only aim is to study and study, teach people. In previous class, Bhanteji has studied, teach the Yamakavaga, Appamaga, and Chittavaga also, they are completed. But again, Bhanteji has started with the Yamakavaga, first Yamakavaga, that is, first Gatha of the Yamakavaga. Bhanteji has talked about how the Buddha became, Siddhartha Gautama became the Buddha, how he got the, at the age of 35, he got the Sambodhi at Bodh Gaya under the peepal tree. So from that, he became a Sambhasam Buddha at the age of 35 years, and up to the age of 80, he is traveling all around the North India part, and then he was teaching the Dhamma all his life. That is Sambhasam Buddha. After the Parinipana of the Buddha, so there was Patamasangayana at the Rajgriha, and in that Rajgriha, there are 500 Arhants who recited the Dhamma. And they have recited Sutta Peter, Vinaya Peter, and Abhidhamma Peter. So, we should learn the Bodhikokya Dhamma. We should study Dhammapada. It is good for us. In the today's class, Bhanteji will be taking about Dhammapada. So, Dhammapada has 26 verses, 423 gathas, and it contains 305 stories in this Dhammapada. So today, the Bhanteji is teaching us the first gatha of the Yamakavagga. So Yamakavagga is a Dhammapada, basically is a Sutta Pitaka, Khuddaka Nikaya, and that is a Dhammapada Pali in Khuddaka Nikaya, Dhammapada Pali, and in that Dhammapada Pali, the first vagga is Yamakavagga. So I'll read the gatha. Mano Pupa Nama Dhamma, Mano Shetha Mano Maya, Manasache Paduthena, Hasati Va Karoti Va, Tatolam Dukkha Manaveti, Chakkava Vato Padam. So, the literal meaning of this gatha is, we will try to learn the word by word. Mano pupa nama dhamma, that is, all mental phenomena have mind as their forerunner. In the sense that mind is the most dominant and it is the cause of the other three mental phenomena, that is namely feeling, that is Vedana, perception, that is Sanya, and mental formation of the mental concomitants, that is Sankhara. So we have already studied in Abhidhamma that Chitta, Chetsika, Rupa, Nibbana. And it, we know that the Chitta, Chetsika is a Nama Rupa, and the Nama contains Vedana Kanda. Sanyaka, this basically Chetsika contains Vedana Kanda, Sanyakanda, and Sankhara Kanda. And Mana, that Chitta, is contains the Vyana Kanda. Consciousness, Vyana, as their forerunner, because although they arise simultaneously with the mind, they cannot arise if the mind does not arise. So, here we have already studied that Chitta Chetsika, Ekupada, Eku Niroda, Eka Alambana, Eka Vartuka. So, whenever the consciousness arises, the mental factors also arises, the Chetsika also arises. When it settles down, it is Niroda. So, when there is no chitta, there is no chetsika also. It takes only one alambana, that one object it takes, and one vattuka. Chakku, sota, gana, whatever the vattu is. So, this is the meaning of the manapubbanga dhamma. So, manapubbanga dhamma is always a forerunner. It is a leader. It is leader like a prime minister. When the prime minister comes, after that, all ministers come. So, whenever Chitta is there, the Chetsika has also arises together. Manasacheda paduthena. The meaning is, and manasi cha pasannena. Manasa means intention or volition, that is Chetana. Volition. It leads to the performance of violation action, both good and evil. This violation and result action constitute karma, and karma always follow one to produce result. Chakkupala blindness, verse 1, was the consciousness of his having acted with the evil intention in a previous existence, and Matta Kundalika. Happy existence in the Tabatissa celestial world. Verse 2 was the result of the mental devotion. Mano Pasada to Buddha. So here, the Mano Pupama Dhamma is, that is the leader of the, is of the forerunner, the Mana is. And Dukkha. Dukkha in this context means suffering or physical or mental pain. Misfortune, unsatisfaction, evil consciousness, etc. And the rebirth in the lower planes of existence or in the lower state of the human society if born in the human world. So these are the meaning of the word, and now I will read out the meaning of the whole verse. All mental phenomena have mind as their forerunner. They have mind as their chief. They are mind-made. If one speaks or acts with the evil mind, dukkha follows him just as the wind follows the hoof prints of the ox that draws the cart. So, this is the story. This is the main meaning of this gatha. I will also tell in Marathi. Manopubhanga dhamma ani manomaya, manosetha manomaya, manasache paduthena bhasati va karoti, tatonam dukkha manaveti, chakka bhavato padam. Ya gadeta artha samjhun sangtana, man je ahe, chitta je ahe, he leader sarkha ahe, forerunner ahe, pahile yetate, ani tyachyanantar chetsika utpanna hotat,
आपण आपल्याला माहिती आपण स्टडी एक उपवाद एक एक निरोध एक आलंबन एक वत्तुक आणि नाम इज ऑलवेज विज्ञान खंड वेदना खंड संया खंड संखार खंड सो वी हॅव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड दॅट वी नो दॅट द नाम रूप इज मेटॅलिटी अँड फिजिकॅलिटी सो नाम रूप इज द होल युनिव्हर्स our mind is always the entire loka the chittena niyata loka whole body follows the chitta and chitta has a power so whatever we are sitting now talking eating so our mind is always a forerunner so this gatha reads like this this meaning of the gatha is all mental phenomena have mind as their forerunner they have mind as their chief they are mind made if one speaks or acts with the evil mind dukkha follows it just as the wheel follows the hoof prints of the ox that draws the cart sridhar apan vasati va karo mhanje manat kayavacha manane जर अकुशल जर आपल्या मनात असेल आपण अकुशल लोभ दोष मोहा कुठली गोष्ट करत असू तर त्यानंतर दुःख हे त्याप्रमाणे बैलगाडीचे चाका बैलगाडीचे चाक ज्याप्रमाणे त्या बैलांच्या पायांच्या खुनांवर चालत येतं त्याप्रमाणे दुःख हे सुद्धा आपल्याला फॉलो करत या गाठीचा अर्थ असा समजून सांगितलेला आहे Yes,
Bhante. Okay, this is his story. So basically, this gatha mana in the Dhamma, achita and chitisika arising together. So according to this gatha, mana sachi padukhina, padukha mana, the evil mind. Evil mind means akusala chittas. Okay? So, suppose akusala chitta has, two types of akusala chitta. Lobamula chittas. Other than how many dhamma, how many chittas you got there? So, manasa dukta, mana dukta, akusala chitta, dosamula chitta. So how many dhamma, how many chittasika there, yeah? Okay, mana dukta, bhavamula chittas. So other than how many dhamma, how many chittasika is there? So we should understand by this way, according to Abhidhamma viewpoint. So Abhidhamma subject is especially for study, tripirkat. Essence of Pirikat. To know clearly, definitely, that is the Buddha message. So that's why the Abhidhamma subject also necessarily do know for, three Pirikat knowledge. So here, Manopavingama Dhamma. Mana is 89-121. Dhamma is the 52 chittasikas. Okay? Manopavingama Dhamma means chitta 89-121. Okay? So we will talk about Abhidhamma subject, these chitta chittasikas. So according to Dhamma, there is a chittasika, the 52. Okay? That is a natural chitta chittasika. But how about this gatha? Manasa Padukta. So other than all of the 89-121 chitta, some are kushala chitta, some are akushala chitta. So here, manasa chi Padukta means akushala chitta. Now akushala chitta also 12 types of akushala chitta, lobha, a dosa, two, moha, two. So eight to two. So at the time, Dhamma Chittisika is a harmony there, according to, you know, Chittisika chapters. So 27 Chittisika is there. So if the mana, lobha, that is a Dhamma Chittisika is a species, you know, society, association there. If the mana dosa, Dhamma is which is a harmony, a chittisika there. If the mana, according to mana, moha, so that is a Dhamma is a harmony chittisika. So anyway, manasaji brahutina is 12 types of agusala chittas. So especially dosa mula chittas. Dosa mula chittas. That's why panati Pashti Karoti, the actions that come in. So Panadi Pada, Frusavasa, Sapaplaba, something like this. Some actions that come in. So anyway, the we should go to that story. Okay, stories very easily for your people. Nachakupala Thera, the Bhante, Chakupala, the blind monk, the blind Thera. So basically, he is from Sravati. He was born in the rich family. So he became monk, okay, after listening to Dhamma. And then he go to the forest with the other monks for rainy season. He practice Dhamma, so finally lost his eye. Because of no sleeping, day and night, only walking, only sitting. That's why AI is come out to us, his eye finally lost. He not use medicine properly. So the doctor gave medicine for eye. The problem is not sitting and lying on the bed. So this is the drawing. Medicine is not coming properly, his eye. One time, two times, three times. So the one is roka, dizziness. Another is the dhamma. So finally he choose dhamma. Not lying on the bed, not sleeping on the bed. That's why medicine not coming inside his eye. That's why not the effect coming to his eye. So finally he lost eye, but he got enlightenment. He became arahant. So that's why he is the blind man. So after that, he reached to Sravati, stay in the Jidavana monastery. So something like this is the background story there. While residing at the Jidavana monastery in Sravati, the Buddha adhered by the one of this book with the reference to Chakupala Bandeji. Chakupala Bandeji stories are not available in other books. Especially only in Dhammapada. On one occasion, the Thera Chikupala, they came to the pay homage to the Buddha at the Jidavana monastery. One night, while the basin up and down and meditation, the Thera accidentally stepped on the same incense. So he lived in the Chidavana monastery. Yeah, in Sairo monastery there. So one night, because of the rain, after rain, the sun inside come up from earth. The bandage, after night, he come up from his temple. No chingama, the basin up and down. Chingama, that is meditation, walking meditation. So he can't see any incense. That's why he stepped on sun incense there. That is not intentionally, accidentally. Intentionally means with the mind, with the chitta, with the chirana. Chirana ham bhikkhave kammam varami. Chirana is the karma. The karma is with the reflection there. Bhante stepped on sun and says, that is not with the intentionally, accidentally, without chirana, without karma. Sometimes we do something with the intention, with the mind. Sometimes accidentally, without karma, without chirana. Sometimes I believe the fall with the back dog. So, accidentally, this dog died. This is accidentally, not intentional. So, according to Buddhism, that is intentionally, is chirana, there is the karma. The karma is with the karma flow. One is in there. So Bhanteji accidentally stepped on the sun incense in the morning. Some bhikshus visit to Thera, they found the dead incense. You know, some visit up Bhante, visit to his temple. They saw, they see, oh, it says, death on the way. They thought, they elapsed the Thera. This is because of Thera. The bandage he stayed on this incense. Why? So they report to the Metta of the Buddha. They impounded the Buddha. The Chikupala Bandiji, the friend of his temple, the sun incense, the death on the way. Because of him, he stepped on at night. This is Agustila. This is the Barnard part. This is Agustila karma. So this visitor, Bhikshu Sangha, reported the Buddha. The Buddha asked the visitor Bhante, do you see the Thera, the killing the insect? So at the time, we don't see that we visit the temple only in the morning. At night, that is happening there. So at the time, the Buddha said, when you, they answer in the negative, okay, they don't see. But the Buddha said, just as you had not seen him killing, okay, so also he had not see these living the incest. He did not see. He's the blind man. He blind person. As the monk Chakupa already attained the arahant. He's arahant. Arahanta Bhante. He could have no intention of the killing, but not wish to kill, because Aranda is no loba, no dosha, no moha, no akushala, no kushala also. Parama. The Arahanta is no Akushala, no Akushala. Okay, that's why no more life, no result of Dharma. So, he did not see. He is the Arahant. He no attention or killing. He know is quiet, innocent. He not, you know, any offense there. So, why Chakupala Bandeji, the blind, although he was Arahant, this monks asked the question to the Buddha, why he blind was, even though he is the Arahant Bande. The Buddha told the following story, because of his previous karma. The karma cause, karma phala is effect, cause and effect there. Cause and effect, karana phala, karma phala. Cause and effect. Ashin, the reaction there. Ashin, the reaction, reflection. Chakupala was a physician, doctor, and one of the, his past assistants in the, one of the life in the previous. He had deliberately made the woman, the patient, the blind. Additionally, he made the woman, the patient, the blind. That woman that has promised him to become his slave, together with his children, after her eyes, the words completed, the cure, she give promise, if that you, the cure is my eye, I will be slaves for you, together with my children. This is a big problem because she gave promise. The fear in that she had their children, the world have to become slaves. She lied to the physician. She told him that her eyes were getting worse. In fact, there was a perfectly cured. Even though her eyes now buddhas and the girl position, she talk lying. My eyes not good, more bad. The physician doctor knew she was deceiving him. So in the revenge, he gave her another ornaments, which had made the heart totally blind. This physician, they gave some medicine to the blind, the heart aunt. As a result of his evil deed, the physician, the lost his eyesight many times. And his later, the assistants, the day to Nibbana, day to Nibbana. Like the water with, whatever we choose, water. The stone, with the stone inside water. This is the wave coming to, you know, beach. One, but many vibrate to come. He did one time, but he lost eyesight. They do neighbor. Then the Buddha spoke in verse as follows, or may the phenomena have my as like this. Or that at the end of the discourse, 30,000 bhikkhus attained arhats together with the analytical insight. But it's some reader. There is to become arahant with the power. Yeah, this is the story. That's why according to this, you know, according to this, manasachi bhruktina. So, chitta is dosa mula chittas. Okay? Dosa mula chittas. So, there is a dhamma is how many chittasika there? Yeah? 22 chittasika is there, according to Abhidhamma. So, yeah, manopovingama dhamma, yeah, mana is dosa mula chitta, according to story. Okay, dhamma is 22 chittasikas. Okay, we should see that. Because of that mind, this is dosa mula chitta, ashin the make to blind. You know, this is evil ashin. So resides the tadonan dukkha manuit. Every after that, you know, there's eyesight, the loss in his life, the day to neighbor. Because his karma is followed to him, like the weed to follow the footprints of the house that drives at the cart. So that's why Tatona, after that is, you know, the mode, the importance for our life. Okay, Upasaka, about story, please sketch in some point. Okay?
Yes, Bhante, yes.
So, after learning this meaning of this Gatha, in this Dhammapada verse, in the Dhammapada book, the story of the Tera Chakrapala is given. So, it's while residing at the Gaidhani monastery in the Savatthi, the Buddha uttered verse number 1 of this book with reference to Chakrapala, a blind Tera. He Gatha, Bhagavan Buddha, ne jeva Gaidhani monastery mein asthana, Savasthila, he Gatha, pahili Gatha mandleli ahe. Manupagamma dhamma, manubhaya, manusetta, manubhaya. Sir, yachati story samjhun sangtana, Buddha, the story sangtana, ahe ashi story. On one occasion, the Thera Chakrapala came to pay homage to the Buddha at the Jetavana monastery. One night, while placing up and down in the meditation, the Thera accidentally stepped on some insects. In the morning, some bhikkhu visited the Thera, found the dead insect. They thought ill of the Thera and reported the matter to the Buddha. So, Chakrapala Thera, when he became arahant, when he went to the Aranya and he was continuously walking and sitting, and the air come up and he got no effect of the medicine on his eyes. So he became a blind. So because he was not sleeping, he was not sitting. So the effect of the medicine could not reach to his eye. And finally he became blind. So then he continued his practice. Afterward he become arahant. So after becoming arahant, he visited the Jetavana monastery. So because he was blind, so one night he was doing meditation, walking meditation, accidentally stepped on some insects, and the insects were killed. So in the morning, some Thera, some bhikkhu monks went there to meet the Thera, and they found the dead insect. So they had ill thoughts in his mind about the Thera, and they report this matter to the Buddha. The Buddha asked them, when they had seen the Thera, the killing of the insect, the Buddha asked them whether they had seen the Thera killing the insect. When they answered in the negative, The Buddha said, just as you had not seen him killing, so also he has not seen those living insects. Besides, as the Thera has already attended Aranship, he could not have no intention of killing, and so was quite innocent. On being asked why Chakkupala was blind, although he was an Arhanta. So here that monk who had a bad thought in his about the Chakkupala Thera, he reported this matter that the Thera has killed the insect. So Buddha has asked that he is a blind person and he has no intention to kill the insect. So there is no panadipata, there is no killing. So when the monk asks why he became blind, the Buddha told the following story. Chakkupala was a physician in one of his past existence. So Chakkupala was a doctor, he was a physician. Once he had deliberately made a woman patient blind, that woman had promised him to become his slave, together with their children, if their eyes were completely cured. So the one lady, she has a problem, eye problem, and she went to Chakkupala, their doctor, and she asked him that, if you cure him, I will become the slave, your slave, whole life, along with my sons. Fearing that woman has promised him to become the slave together with her children, if her eyes were completely cured. Fearing that she and her children would have to become slaves, he lied to the physician. So, the Chakkupala physician has cured that lady, and she was good at her eyesight. But the bad thought came into her mind, and she falsely told the Chakkupala that he is not able to see. She told him that her eyes were getting worse than when, in fact, they were perfectly cured. The physician knew she had deceived him. So in revenge, so now he knows, the physician knows that she is deceiving him. So in the revenge, he gave her another ointment which made her totally blind. So the doctor knew that she is telling lie, she is deceiving him. So he got the revenge in his mind. So he, Dosamura Chitta has appeared in his mind. So he gave another ointment which made her totally blind. So, due to that effect of the ointment, that lady had become totally blind. As a result of this evil deed, the physician lost his eyesight many times in his later existence. So, due to that Doshmoola Chitta, here Bandeji has talked about that Akushala, that is particularly Akushala Chitta 12, is that Akushala Chitta, Doshmoola Chitta 2, and the Chetsika is 22 Chetsika. With this 20th Chetsika, that is Dhamma and Doshmoola Chitta. So due to that, and that is because his mind was with the revenge, full of revenge. So that was his mind was fully occupied. Akushala Chitta. Manasa Acheta Paduttena. So Bhasa Diva Karo. So he did action. That he gave the ointment. So that lady become totally blind. So as a result of this evil deed, the physician lost his eyesight many times in his later existence. When the Buddha spoke in the verses as follows, all mental phenomena have mind as their forerunner. They have mind as their chief. They are mind made. If one speaks or acts with the evil mind, dukkha follows him just as the wheel follows the hoofprints of the ox that draws the cart. So, at the end of the discourse, 30,000 bhikkhus attended Aranship together with the analytical inside Pati Sambhita. So when this Katha, this Dhamma is given by Buddha, at that time 30,000 of bhikshu he arhant dhale with Pati Sambhita. That is analytical insight. So here Bhanteji has talked about the action is remains because he has deceived him. And here the chitta is the dosamala chitta with 22 the chetsika dhamma. The result is he lost. Means the because he took a revenge, he lost his eyesight in many existence, future existence. So that is how the Chakkupala Thera was blind. So this Vyasa is explained like this. He has Bhante. If anybody has some questions, they can ask. Those who are not able to understand something.
So, Upaska.
Yes, Bhante.
Thank you for your presentation. Okay. Now the time is 10. So we want to move some time for the Abhidhamma, the object. Okay. Today we want to introduce this Abhidhamma to Sangaho. So Abhidhamma Sangaho, we should use the Bhante Bhikkhu boring, okay? Comprehensive menu Abhidhamma. That is a book is available in the internet. You can download it easily. Okay, Abhidhammattha Sangaho. The way is it called? This is the Abhidhamma. Abhidhamma, okay? Vinaya Sutta Abhidhamma. Vinaya Sutta Abhidhamma. The Vinaya Abhidhamma Sutta Abhidhamma Abhidhamma Abhidhamma. So Abhidhamma is the including and the three Abhidhammas. So now we have a study that is Abhidhammattha Sangaho is a basis notes box. Not including and the canonical text. The composition by Bhante Aniruddha in the 9th century, 12th century times the AD, 12th century. So that is the box, the famous, even though the bookless, the less the numbers of the pages there. That is the book has 9 chapters, like Chitta, Chidasika, Bhagayinaka, Viti, Viti, Mokta. So we should study first chapters about Chittas. Okay, Chitta. So Chitta Mana. Easy to say that is mind. So translation that is consciousness. So Chitta is a consciousness. So before the study that is the Chaita chapters, the Bhante Aniruddha he introduced 4 kinds of pramatha, which is the Chaita, Chittasika, Rupa, Nipa. These are called pramatha. The pramatha means ultimate reality. Prama, the utter ultimate reality. The final truth. The prama utter, the finite truth in this universe. Absolute truth. So according to Abhidhamma. So four kinds of Brahmattha are there. Yeah? What are they? Chitta, consciousness. Chittasika, mental factors, Rupa, Metta, and Nibbana. Chitta, Chittasika, Rupa, Nibbana. Chitta, Chittasika, Rupa, Nibbana. That is Pali. These four are called Brahmattha. In English, ultimate reality, ultimate truth, a final truth, absolute truth in this world. Chitta, Chittasika, Rupa, Nibbana. There is no Buddha, no Dhamma, no Sangha, no Bhikshu, Bhikshuni, Upasaka, Upasika, no God, no mathematics, no scientist. Only Chitta, Chittasika, Rupa are called four kinds of Brahmattha. Essence of world, essence of universe. Chitta, Chittasika. That is Nama. Rupa is Rupa. Nibbana is free from Nama Rupa. So Chitta, Chittasika, Rupa, Nibbana. Chitta, Chittasika is all Nama. Rupa is Rupa. Nama Rupa? Nama Rupa in this world? What about Nibbana? Nibbana is free from Nama Rupa, free from universe, free from samsara. No nama, no rupa. So in this world is the nama and rupa is there. Yeah? So everything are connected with the nama and rupa. Whenever we see nama or rupa, whenever we hear nama rupa, whenever we touch nama or rupa, yeah, we should consider about that. According to that is a Brahmattha, like the human beings, we are Nama Rupa, the mind and matter. Not only Chitta Chittasika, Rupa also, physical body. Nama Rupa is a mentality, mental body. So we have the Namarupa, dog, Namarupa, monkey, because they are living life. Namarupa, fish, Namarupa. Aya, Aya, water, there is only Rupa. So whenever we see, we hear only Nama and Rupa, we should know, identify. This is the Nama Rupa Pricharanyana in Vipassana, knowledge for liberation, for the Nibbana. So we should know this is Nama, this is the Rupa. This is one of the knowledge, great knowledge, Nama Rupa. Prachara vipassana jnana. We should know clearly which is what is nama, what is okay, like this. This book, Rupa, this pansa, only Rupa. So around the world, around the universe, some are nama, some are Rupa. Some are together Nama and Rupa, like the human, the animals, the Deva, the Brahma, the Nama Rupa there. What about forests? What about mountain? What about ocean? What about rivers? What about air? What about fire? Yes. Living or not? The being or not? If the living beings, yeah, both nama rupa there. Who one which is non-living? That is only rupas. Only rupa. So anyway, this chaita, chittisika, the rupa, the nibbana is all called pramattha, ultimate, the realities and this universe. So everything are connected with these, you know, the four, you know, ultimate realities. We should know nama rupa, that is the Buddha, no? Different condition. Nama is the rupa, the Buddha. Oh, Buddha is a human being. That's why nama rupa. What about Aranda, Sariputra, Moggallana, Anna? Oh, they are human. That's why Namarupa there. Buddha, Namarupa, me, Namarupa, same or not? Yeah, same. Same pattern. So me and dog, monkey. Yeah, same. Because of Namarupa. Pattern is the same. The form is the difference. Quality is the difference. The difference between the Aranda and us, Buddha and us. Quality, only quality difference. Animal and human, they have the Namarupa only. So basically, no he, no she, no me, no human, no animal, no Deva, no Brahma. Only Namarupa. This is the final truth. This is the truth. This is the liberation of samsara. That's why in the Vipassana knowledge, nama rupa prichira jnana. Nama rupa prichira jnana. Sometimes we confuse nama or rupa. Something like this. In Milena Pinya, Tim Milena and Maninashi in a discussion about that. Where is Maninashi? So basically only Namaru, no Maninashi, but the concept that is compassionate, true also there. You know, for Buga, for, you know, communicate each other. That's why Papa, Mama, brother, sister, auntie, uncle, teacher, police, minister, Bhante, Upasaka, Upasika. This is the concept. This is the Panyati. For easy to communicate each other. That is no final truth. That is no final truth. Just labor, just name. Basically, the nama rupa, chitta chittisika rupa is relatives there. So anyway, this universe only two, the one, the nama, two rupa. Okay, one and two. So four kinds of brahmata is like this, the Abhidhammattha, singha is, you know, basically talking about chitta, talking about chittisika, talking about rupa, talking about nibbana, but the nibbana is you not talk too much, very less. So especially the Abhidhammattha Singha book talk about chittas, the 89-121, Kusala chitta, Akusala chitta, Vipaka chittas, Kriya chittas. Talking about chittisika, the 52 chittisikas. Talking about rupa, 28 types of rupa, this is Buddha physics, Buddha science. If you want to know Buddha the science, knowledge, they should study the, you know, rupa chapters, the rupa chapters. So Abhidhamma, Abhidhammattha Singha, Abhidhamma means only Chitta Chittisika Rupa Nibbana. Abhidhamma, this is Abhidhamma. So Abhidhammattha Singha, they're talking about Chitta Chittisika Rupa Nibbana. So we were studying about that Abhidhammattha Singha. So to know Chitta Chittisika Rupa Nibbana. Okay, I want to introduce like this. So we will talk more in next class. Okay, Upasika. The Vaishali.
Yes, Bhante.
Upasika Vaishali. Please explain, okay, something about this class, this subject.
Yes, Bhante. So today I'm very thankful to Bhante. Thank you, Bhante, so much for teaching us. And it is so wonderful because learning the Abhidhamma separately and the Dhammapada separately is different. It's because Abhidhamma is, like everyone says, is such a dry subject. We don't understand that clearly because not related to day-to-day lives. That is what people understand. But Dhammapada are the verses and stories of day-to-day lives and what happens in the society around us. So from this perspective, Bhante, how the Abhidhamma is integrated into our day-to-day lives, we come to understand, Bhante, when we have the Dhammapada and the Abhidhamma understanding together. So Bhante, thank you so much. And just about today's class, that we started with Bhante explaining us the first chapter of the Dhammapada, that's the Yamakvagga. And in Yamakvagga, we see that they are in pairs. Whatever understanding is given, whatever teaching of the Buddha is about the Dhamma is in pairs. So Bhante explained to us what is Paduttana. Paduttana is a Kusala in Abhidhamma. And Pasannena is Kusala in Abhidhamma. So this is how the Sutta and the Abhidhamma are correlating in the first verse. So first and second verse of the Dhammapada. And like Bhante introduced us with how many verses, how many stories, how many Vagga are there in the Dhammapada. And from that we understand it's a big number of verses, that is 423 verses, 305 stories, and 26 vaggas. That means so many specific chapters, number of chapters under one heading, like Yamaka Vagga. So there will be so many verses. So that is just one vagga. There are 26 such vaggas. And the first verse that Bhante explained was about the mana, the mind, the chitta, which is the chitta, which is the vinyana khanda. And so the mana is, man comes first and then follows the dhamma, chetasika. So chetasika again, they are the vedana, sanya, and sankhara khanda. So again, how we are relating to nama rupa in Abhidhamma based on mana and mano pubbangama dhamma, just the first three words are relating to nama and rupa. And whatever nama and rupa, that means the mentality and the physicality, these two things, nama and rupa, which belong to everyone in the universe, that is even the Buddha, everyone are related by nama and rupa. So today Bhante explained to us that how the mind comes first and how important is the mind, because this mind, nama or mano, is the chitta, and chitta na Niyati loko. How the chitta, if we are happy in mind, the first thing, then we feel that the whole universe is very nice, very good. And also our life is very good. So that is how powerful our mind is to make our lives happy. So this is the basic thing Bhante told us. And it is so powerful. It is such a powerful concept in our day-to-day lives. Which, with this idea, if we begin and learn the Dhamma, I think it gives us so much pleasure inside. So it makes us so happy even to study the Dhammapada or Abhidhamma and apply it in our lives just by that experience. At this moment, I feel a lot of happiness in my heart to understand what Bhante is teaching us. And how Bhante also explained us the grammar of dukkha manaveti and sukha manaveti. That it is dukkha anu eti. Anu is following. So how Bhante also explained us a little bit about the grammar of words that are used here. And then the 12 types of akusala chitta, how they are related to, because the paduthena is the akusala chitta in Abhidhamma. So akusala chitta, which are the 8 lobha, 2 dosa and 2 moha moola chittas. So these are the 12 moha akusala moola chitta, which have the hetu of akusala, and how they are related to the Dhamma. Dhamma is the chetasika. So here in this case, when we talk about the akusala, Bhante said, specially when we talk about akusala, we are talking about the dosa moola chitta. So this is another aspect, very important aspect, and specially dosa moola related to kamma. So the kamma which we do are the actions. So how the chitta mana is related to our actions, and also the chitta is also related to the dhamma, that is the chetasika which are 22 chetasikas in case of maximum number of chetasikas are 22 in case of lobha moola chitta, in case of dosa moola chitta also they are 22. So the two stories Bhante, the one story Bhante taught us was about Chakkhupala Thera, and in the Chakkhupala Thera also, how the akusala is the dosa moola chitta, and the action related to akusala, that is like for example Panatipata, for example Musavada, Dinnadana, those kind. But in this case, it is Panatipata. The action of Panatipata. And Bhante also explained us that the story about the Chakkhupala Bhante is not mentioned anywhere in the Tipitaka. It is only mentioned in the Abhidhamma. And Bhante, Chakkhupala, steps on the insects at night. So Bhante Chakkhupala is not intentionally doing it, but doing it accidentally, without Chetana, without Kamma. So, but it is because of the previous kamma that Bhante Chakkhupala has this phala. His previous kamma gives him the phala in this life. And there is another story about he being a doctor. So how he had misused all of that. So just as when other Bhante at Jetavana see that Bhante Chakkhupal is there are insects over there lying dead. So then they go to the Buddha and complain to the Buddha about Bhante Chakkhupala. So Bhante, all those Bhante, the Buddha tells them that just as you have not seen him killing, he also cannot see. So that is how, but he has become enlightened, because even after he has lost his eyes, he was not sleeping properly, not taking care of his eyes in terms of medicines and all that. He chooses the Dhamma, and because he chooses the Dhamma, he becomes enlightened, he becomes an arhat. So this is such a powerful story for all of us to know. And Yeah, and I'm very thankful to Bhante for teaching so wonderful Dhamma and Abhidhamma to us. Thank you so much, Bhante. Thank you so much. And also, I wish to thank Mukesh Ji for translating it to all of us. Yeah, because it is so important that the Marathi translations also, all of us understand very, very much better because it's a native language. So, yeah, so I'm very much thankful to Mukesh Ji for his efforts and for sharing and taking all the efforts for all of us. Thank you so much. Thank you, Bhante. Thank you, Mukesh Ji.
Okay. Thank you for everybody.
Yeah.
So Dhamma Savana, the Dhamma Dishana. So teaching learning is including Dhamma Savana and the Dhamma Dishana. So because of Dhamma Savana, Dhamma Dishana, so Dhamma knowledge the coming. Dhamma knowledge is coming. Chakho Udapari, Jnana Udapari, Aloko Udapari. The rear eye is Chakho, Jnana, knowledge, the rear knowledge. The rear lightness or life, Aloka, no, Aloko Udapari, coming. These are the because listening Dhamma. Teaching the Dhamma. So many kinds of good results will be coming for us because of teaching and learning the case. So after I become Buddha, he thought, I should not teach the mind Dhamma. Mind Dhamma is a very sukuma. Ataka Vachara. Not belong to the any philosophy, religions, logic, atika vachara, beyond the logic. So people interested in logic, philosophy, religions, art, enjoyment. So that's why Buddha thought like this. So I cannot teach. So Sahambati Brahma is coming to request, please teach. Some the people are able to understand your Dhamma, not for all. So, some is ready for the Dhamma. So, because Sahambati Brahma requests, then the Buddha teach. If they not teach, the people no chance to know. No chance to follow. Yeah. So according to that, we try to now teach, trying to listen, trying to discussion also. Okay. You can ask any question. You can discussion.
Bhante, may I ask one question?
Okay.
So, Bhante, in the case of Chakkupala Bhante, and in such case when an arhata, there is some action, then where does that action go, Bhante, if it is not accounted as a kamma phala for the person?
The which action?
The action which other Bhante, they see that the ants are dead.
Yeah, they thought like this.
Yes, Bhante.
This Bhante ji, you know, at night he go outside to walk in meditation. During the time, it's inside the day.
Mm-hmm.
So Bhante ji is a arahant. Arahanta is no condition of no condition for the karma because they are no defilements, okay? No response for that. So the karma is, kusala karma, akusala karma, whatever, like a seed, bija, okay? The bija, the karma planet and the fruit, that is the leaf, the branches, the karma flies like this. So two planet of the seed need water, need lichen, need ground, okay? So even the arahant, they do action as like others, okay? But their karma seed is no karma planet, okay, trees. Because there are no condition, water, defilements, no earth, and then no light. So, which is support the seed to come out, planets. So for us, lobha, dosha, moha, mana, all our defilements are ready. The good condition, whatever we do, action, seed, planets are coming, in the coming. Because we have the condition, the ground, water, and the lightness also, That's why this is the karma is coming in the given research. That is belong to that action. So Arahanta, there is no condition for the given any research of the planets. That's why they are. Avijaya dua asisa viraga nirora sankhara niroro. So they are no avijja, no moha, no lobha, no dosa. That's why they are sankhara, not coming. Karma not coming. Sankhara, avijja, vinyana. So no more life for them. Because of no karma. No karma means no sankhara. Why? Because no avijja, ignorance, moha, no lobha, no dosha. So that's why Bandiji, the Ashin is no reflection for them, for him.
Thank you, Bhante. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
So we should do conclusion today. Doka padacha ni doka bhya padasa ni bhya soka padasa ni soka hundu sabi bhani no ita udacha ambe samadha punya sabra sabi dewa numora nusabha sambari sabiya dan nandarandu sadaya sila rakhanu sabra bhavana pirra hundu kichanu dewa dagada sabi pura balapada pishika nisa yambala randa nisa di china rakhambana mi sabha so Owa do sabha minglara kandu sabha dewada sabha bura nubhavena sabha dhamma nubhavena sabha sangha nubhavena srasukhi bhundu de sabhi diya vivijandu sokoroko vinasandu madhe bhundu nraya sukhi diga yukoba wa vivarana silesa nichan uda pachayino chattaro dhamma vodandu ayu vuno sukhambalam
Sadhu. Thank you very much, Bhante.
Vandami Bhante.
Sadhu.
Vandami Bhante.